This disciple came to know the scoldings of my guru is for my betterment. He started loving. Then he became a wonderful Vaishnava. Very wonderful Vaishnava. Then he was continuing. He was preaching. He made many, many disciples. And one day he felt bad. Whatever it is, I took the rock and went in. I wanted to kill my guru. That's a sinful thing. That thought was a sinful thing. I should atone for it. I should punish myself for it. So he went and asked his guru, Gurudev, I have a question. Gurudev said, yes, what? If a disciple is thinking of killing his guru, what punishment should be given to him? He did not mention that's for himself. He's asking about himself. Or he didn't mention anything. If a disciple is thinking of killing his guru, what punishment should be given to him? And the guru also doesn't know he is mentioning about himself. The guru said, that is the most grievous, abominable sin a person can commit. He should take a pit and stand inside the pit and cover his body till neck with the husk of the paddy and set fire. And he did that. He did not reveal this to anyone. He took a pit. This great person, great Vaishnav, got inside the pit, covered himself with the husk and set it fire. The particular aspect of this husk is it will not catch fire and burn like that. The husk will slowly, it's like what do you call, you know, it's like a charcoal it is. Slowly it will burn and burn and burn. And he lit fire and started writing this book called Sri Krishna Vilasam. Wonderful Sanskrit treatise. Such a wonderful work it is. He wrote about Krishna so beautifully, Sri Krishna Vilasam. And the book is incomplete. And you know why. Before finishing the book, his body got burnt and he left his body. So this incomplete book, a Sanskrit book called Sri Krishna Vilasam. A Vaishnava Acharya who really did this in his life. So this is the correction this person did. Initially he was hating his guru and one day he corrected. That is all. His life became very successful. It is explained in Mahabharata also. One day Kunti is crying and weeping and with tears as her garments turned wet. And she's speaking to Vidura Mahatma, my dear brother, look at me. Look at my situation. I am living like a beggar in Dhritarashtra's palace and their children are insulting my children so badly. Sending our children to jungle, not feeding them properly, treating them like slaves, insulting. How can I hold on? Then Vidura Mahatma said, Kunti Maharani, I don't know why this is happening. I don't have any answer to stop this also. I can't help you in any other way. But one thing I can do. I can give you a tip where you can convert this pain into pleasure. Then Kunti Maharani asked, what is that? Then Vidura said, what is the difference between starving and fasting? What is the difference between starving and fasting? Both the days, anyway, we don't have food. If you starve also, you don't get food. If you fast also, you don't get both of the days, no food. But starving day, it is forced upon us. Fasting, we have voluntarily decided. So on the fasting day, we don't feel the torture. But on the starving day, you feel the torture. You feel that pain because it is forced upon. When I go and tell somebody else, Prabhuji, I am an egoistic person, it doesn't hurt me. But somebody else tells us, you are an egoistic, then it hurts us a lot. But the statement is same. Both the statements are same. It has the same meaning. When I go and say, I am egoistic, when another person says, you are egoistic, both has the same meaning. But when I say, it doesn't hurt. But somebody else points his finger on me, it hurts a lot. So, when something is forced upon you, next 12 years you have to remain in jungle. It is forced upon you. It will be painful. So what you do? Convert it into a tapasya. You plan. You take it voluntarily. Convert that pattini, that starvation into vrata. And he gave the secret. And Yudhishthira told his brothers, next 12 years we are going to do tapasya. This is the time for tapasya. That's it. They were enjoying the 12 years. Because it was not forced upon. They were enjoying the 12 years. So, Vidura said, this is the lesson. Simple lesson you have to learn. Life goes on. So, Manaparam Karanam Amanantri. My mind is the cause and reason for my suffering, for my all the pains in my life, my bad, everything. Mind is the cause. If we know how to train our mind, life becomes successful. This is a beautiful Avanti Brahmana, Bhikshu Gita explained. It's a very nice shloka actually. 11th canto, 23rd verse and 42nd shloka. 42nd shloka. So, thank you very much. So, please try to implement whatever things possible in your life. And utilize this time to chant more number of rounds, reading more books, applying more principles. And actively you can have your online satsang and preaching programs. And Guru Maharaj was telling you one of these days, many people all over the world are panicked or are disturbed now. So Guru Maharaj was telling it was a nice time to preach. Because they are all suffering and you have the medicine. And if you can give this medicine, and then if they take it across, their life is successful. Many are scared. Guru Maharaj in the lecture said, the Mexican president or some rulers in the country are telling, please depend on God. He is telling his citizens, everything is gone out of our hands. The France or Spain ruler or president, whoever, the first man, he said, now everything is gone out of our hands. So please pray. So now the leaders are saying, please pray, please do. That is the only thing. You know, Kejriwal, the chief minister of Delhi, he said, please read Bhagavad Gita. Because they know things are going out of their hands. They can't stop it. So even they are saying. So Guru Maharaj said, very nice time to preach. Maybe we can reach more people. Thank you very much. And thank you to all the senior devotees, Raj Pran Prabhu and all the other devotees. Thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. Hare Krishna.